Since the mid-2000s, the Monotub tech has continued to be one of the most popular and effective methods for growing mushrooms indoors. They're designed to be both an incubation space and a fruiting chamber. No transfers and no special equipment is needed from inoculation to first flush. Because the classic Monotub design uses passive air exchange through filtered holes, CO2 can build up inside the tub and limit the grower to species that can tolerate higher CO2 concentrations. This makes it nearly impossible to grow a number of delicious edible species that are very sensitive and need abundant fresh air in order to grow properly. There's a way that you can modify your Monotub to accommodate species previously excluded from the Monotub tech. In this video, I'm going to show you how to modify your homemade tub so you can grow even more species of mushrooms. If you're experimenting with new species or just want to grow edible mushrooms like the blue oyster, black king, or lion's mane, you'll want to consider adding a fresh air exchange fan and humidifier to your tub. Even if you're only working with CO2 tolerant species, like the medicinal mushrooms most often associated with monotub cultivation, you'll want to consider modifying your tub with some of these automated systems as a way to be more hands-off. All of this comes down to what mushroom species you want to grow and what environmental conditions they require to reach maturity. These environmental conditions include fresh air exchange, humidity, light, and temperature. When it comes to monotubs, humidity and fresh air can be managed by installing a fan and humidifier. If you don't have either, you can also introduce more fresh air by removing filter patches, but this can lead to increased moisture loss, so you'll need to mist to compensate. Temperature is a very important variable that should be monitored closely. It can greatly affect how a mushroom species grows or if it will grow at all. Light informs the direction of fruiting and color of fruiting bodies. It can also help mushrooms produce certain chemical compounds, such as vitamin D. Each of these variables is critical, but keep in mind that genetics and substrate play an important role too. Clean substrate with the right nutrients and vibrant genetics will make a huge difference, no matter what you're growing. The modifications I'm going to show you are specific to fruiting mushrooms as opposed to incubating substrate and should only be used once your substrate has fully colonized. I'll say that again, only modify your tub's conditions when your substrate is ready to fruit. You'll know your monotub is colonized and ready to fruit when it's fully covered with dense mycelium. So make sure that if you plan on using automated systems, keep them off while your monotubs are colonizing. Today I'm using North Spore's FAE mini fan, which comes with its own speed controller. It's meant to fit over 2-inch holes, but you could potentially make it work with other monotub designs too. As you can see, it has 4 screw holes on each corner, which I'll use to mount to the side of this monotub. For this, you'll want to use a 9/64-inch drill bit. I also have a repeat cycle timer, which will allow me to control when the fan turns on and for how long. Certain species don't need as much airflow, and you can dial in their exact needs using a cycle timer. This cycle timer is optional, but it can be useful for anyone who wants to be more conservative with fresh airflow. Pumping less air into your tub means that you won't need to have your humidifier running as frequently, and it also lengthens the lifespan of your fan. This plugs into the wall and can be controlled by these dials here once you've connected your fan. Before installing your fan, double check that the North Spore logo is facing out. This will push air into the tub, not out, to create a positive pressure system. The reason I'm using a positive system rather than a negative, which would be pumping air outside of the tub, is to reduce the amount of spores entering my living space. I'm going to remove the top filter patch and use painter's tape to secure the fan over the hole. From here, I'm going to use my drill bit to mark each corner. I can now remove the fan and puncture these holes using a drill. Lastly, I can secure my fan to my monotub. Make sure to place the screen on the back side of the fan before installing. I'm also going to plug my fan into the cycle timer and test my system to make sure everything is functioning properly. Alternatively, if you don't want a fan, you could remove the filter patches to introduce more fresh, oxygen-rich air to circulate within the tub. Which filters you remove and how many will depend on the environmental conditions and what you're growing. By doing this, you'll just want to make sure that your substrate doesn't dry out. More TLC is required since you may have to spray it with water several times a day. you decide to use a fan for fresh air exchange, you'll also want to add a humidifier. That's because as you pump fresh air into the tub, you're reducing those ambient humidity levels with drier outside air, and this will quickly dry out your substrate. This MycoMister Mini Humidifier comes with a hose and hose connector, which you can attach to the side of your monotub by removing one of these filter patches. Humidity tends to build up in this area of the hose to the point where it can create a water plug if your humidity is running frequently. You can use some tape or one of these suction cups to secure the hose to the tub. Another option is to place the humidifier below your tub so excess moisture will drain back into the humidifier. Now that my humidifier is attached to my monotub, I'm going to set up my humidity controller. This humidity controller also comes with a sensor, which monitors the ambient humidity inside the tub and signals the humidifier when to turn on and off. I've found that the best way to place the humidity sensor inside a monotub is to cut a small slit in one of the filter patches on the short ends of the tub and fit it through the hole to the other side. Once it's all set up and your humidifier is full of water, you'll want your humidity controller to read around 80 to 90%. This is the ideal humidity for mushroom formation. During pinning, humidity levels should be higher, but please be careful about excess condensation, as it can cause pooling and stress your equipment. Also remember that temperature affects how condensation occurs. The air can hold more moisture at higher temperatures and less at lower temperatures. If your growing space is too cold, your MycoMister won't be able to humidify your tub to the parameters set on your humidity controller. It will be impossible. If you see excessive pooling or condensation, it may signal that you either need to increase the ambient temperature inside your tub, or you should lower your humidity parameters to account for the cooler temperatures. Mushrooms don't photosynthesize, but they are photosensitive, and certain species require ambient light in order to fruit properly. Full spectrum light encourages vegetative growth, primordial formation, the production of vitamin D, and pigmentation. Light also provides a clear direction for the mushrooms to grow towards. If you're growing mushrooms in a dark area, such as a closet, you can add artificial lighting. There are studies that suggest photosensitive fungi are stimulated by certain wavelengths of light. Consider purchasing an LED that allows you to change the color temperature so you have more control over the lighting spectrum. With that being said, lighting needs, including light intensity, spectrum, and duration, will vary from species to species. Beyond bulk substrate, you can use monotubs to grow fruiting blocks. For fruiting species that require higher levels of fresh air exchange, such as oyster mushroom, just cut an X in the block and place it inside the bin. Make sure your systems are on and you're ready to grow. If you're not using the automated system, you can still grow species like shiitake. You'll want to remove the block from the bag, remove a couple filters, and mist with water regularly. Thank you for watching this video. Feel free to let us know what you think about the monotub tech in the comments. We appreciate your feedback and look forward to creating more video content surrounding mushroom cultivation and education. So stay tuned and don't forget to hit that subscribe button to support our channel.